and the back of his head, which as far as they could see was made entirely of creosote. Ringing up his mother in Aberystwyth that evening, Mr. Hopkins was almost over-enthusiastic, stumbled over his words. Calm down, boy, she said. What are you trying to tell me? Mother, mother, in the jar, the thing was his head.
What do you mean the thing was his head, boy?
She spat down the phone. 200 miles away in Dulwich, Edward was feverish and almost unable to impress his mother how urgent it was that she went upstairs and looked for the remains of their father.
Headpiece, headpiece, buried on the high room.
Something about the urgency in his voice impressed her, and she put down the phone. Actually, she put it in the goldfish bowl so she could just he could hear this muted bubbling as she went upstairs. Put it in her hydraulic old person's thing, and she got upstairs, and she opened the room where the remains of her husband were, and sure enough, the head was missing. Fortunately, just at that moment, I came on the radio. I often dream of trains when I'm alone. I ride on them into another zone. I dream of them constantly, heading for paradise, or Basingstoke, or Reading. I often dream of trains when I'm awake. They ride along beside a frozen lake. And there in the buffet car, I wait for eternity, or Basingstoke, or Reading. I often dream of trains till it gets light. The summer turns to winter overnight. The leaves fall so suddenly. The sun sets at 4 o'clock, exactly what I'm dreading. I often dream of trains when I'm with you. I wonder if you dream about them too. I'm waiting for you, baby. 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 And now, hot from the surgical encounters with Destiny Clinic, it's Morris and Andy.
Underneath her sheet,
doesn't care about the car she used to drive. She gets a new one every year. She shuts her past out, that's the way she stays alive. Keep changing oil and changing gear. One thing I completely failed to do, and I should have done it at the start, this was to remove the evil one from my wrist. This looks like an ordinary $40 watch, but inside this is trapped Asmodeus, the 5,000-year-old spirit of all evil, fallen angel. And it's just been, I put it in there, I managed to get it in there by myself, but if anyone sees it coming out during the gig, if you could let us know with kind of hand signals, you know, crosses and things like that. All right. Put it on top of the amp with some flowers. The flowers should be all right. Yeah. Hold it, hold it. I thought I was starting the other song. I was about to begin a ditty in G whilst... Take two. We'll be right back. found his father actually standing in front of the mirror in a dress, but he was wearing a female mask, so it looked incredibly ungainly. He said, "Dad, why don't you just admit you're a transvestite and stop wearing a woman's face when you dress up?" His father turned around to him and he took off his head. There was actually nothing underneath the mask. He never asked his father another personal question again.
I'm a mirror cries from side to side.
As you get older, your early life seems more and more interesting, more golden, richer, deeper colours. In fact, nothing happened at all. Just
Maybe there's no one there at all. Maybe there's no one left to pass. Maybe there's no one there but Paul, living in Shawford after all these years. Standing in the tall but
from Athens, Georgia, it's Peter Buck. Would it could have a little bit more of this in some of the monitors.
Lingers under my eyes.
What does the day know? Why does it try? Okay, Andy has not had any fruit in the dressing room, in case you were wondering what he was doing. But something has come off another thing that he owns, and he's attempting to glue them back together again without glue. When we've done that, we'll carry on with the show. If you want to relax for a while, spin around in circles, read the newspaper, jump up and down, try and remember all the things that you left on your kitchen table before you came out, work out what time you're going to get up in the morning 3 days from now. Figure out which, if you've got both your parents alive, who's going to die first and all the rest of it. We'll be right back. In the original story, Romeo and Juliet were so deeply in love with each other that they died for each other. In my song, Romeo spends most of his time masturbating in front of a mirror while Juliet shoots up heroin with a snake. They're just despicable people. But I didn't invent them, I've just perverted them. I've just put in there, this is actually a Halloween song. It's basically about a pumpkin being tortured and the visions it has while its brain burns. You know, at Halloween you cut the holes in the pumpkin and put the candle inside. I imagine that when you do that, you're burning the pumpkin's soul, and the pumpkin has all these horrible visions of people like Romeo and Juliet being distorted. In the end, the pumpkin just burns away. There's no salvation in this. Song about money.
walking up 6th Avenue when Balloon Man came right up to me. He was round and fat, spherical, with the biggest grin I'd ever seen. He bounced on up toward me, but before we could be introduced, he blew up very suddenly. I guess his name was probably Bruce. And I laughed, and I always do, and I cried. Some strips of skin. So I made a ride on 44th and I washed my hands when I got in. Meanwhile it rained like a slow divorce, and I wish I could ride a horse. And Balloon Man blew up in my hand. Balloon Man blew up in my face. There were loads of them on Bryant Park, so I didn't feel out of place. There must have been a plague of them on the TV when I came home late. They were dazzling marshmallows and then jumping off. So I laugh, like I always do, and I cry, like I cry for you. But the Balloon Man blew up in my hand. Balloon Man blew up in my hand.
Anyway.
short. I wish I was long. But she only wishes that you take her along. I don't know why he never gets anywhere with you. Oh, suck it to me.
P.D. Wigstra, rhythm guitar. People often wonder why, and there's no reason at all, and that's all there is to it. Thank you.
Good night.
Thank you very much.
People often say, well, how come bloodless, over-polite, dead, unfeeling people like you British actually ever manage to reproduce? And I say, I don't really know, but what we do is we sing songs to each other before we mate. And this is the one that I wrote. All my other songs are written by a guy called Clint, it says in the paper. I want to point that out to you, it's true.
Teeth in me just the way I am.
Too much, exploit me in the deanery. It's alright, I got a message for you. Treat me hard and leathery, treat me soft and feathery. Oh, what lovely weathery. I got a message for you. You got a message for me. I got a message for you.